There's a lot that goes on at the Monterey Bay Aquarium that you might not see if you visited here. When our otters aren't on exhibit, they're working to raise stranded pups, which wouldn't survive on their own in the wild. These non-biological mothers rear them and teach them what it means to be a wild otter.
In the wild, sea otter pups normally have a very long and tight dependency with the mother. They are completely naive from the standpoint of survival skills. They can't dive, they can't feed themselves, they can't groom their own coat. So the pup follows the mother around continuously. The two are really never separated for usually an average of about 6 or 7 months. Here at the Monterey Bay Aquarium, the concept for the surrogacy program really developed out of that tight dependency period. We knew that we had to replace the role of that sea otter mother for a fairly extended period of time in order to prepare the pups to be able to survive on their own after they're released.
These otters survive just as well or better than wild otters, and they breed just as well and contribute to the population just like wild otters. So not only does it save these animals from a bad end, it puts them in a place where they're desperately needed, boosting that population of otters and providing all the benefits for those ecosystems.
Elkhorn Slough was chosen as a location for releasing surrogate reared animals because, number one, we knew that there was a small resident population of sea otters up there that would potentially provide the right social situation. We knew that the food items were relatively abundant and the depth of the water was shallow enough that it was relatively easy to learn how to find food and then make the transition from captivity to the wild.
20 years ago, the Elkhorn Slough had only 20 otters and they were all males. It was stagnant, it was clouded, and it was a much less vibrant ecosystem. Today, there are almost 140 sea otters in the Elkhorn Slough, and roughly 60% of the otters are direct descendants of the Monterey Bay Aquarium surrogacy program. We've seen dramatic changes in the Elkhorn Slough due to the rise in the sea otter population. By eating the predators that restricted the eelgrass population, the water is clearer and there's more habitat for fish and other invertebrates like snails and less erosion.
One of the most important criteria for success with the surrogacy program was not just that the animals would survive after they were released, but ultimately that they would contribute reproductively to the wild population. And so the fact that these surrogate reared animals actually have had a positive impact on this local population up in Elkhorn Slough means that this is a very valuable tool moving forward for sea otter conservation throughout California.
Surrogacy works. This experiment that we've been conducting in the Elkhorn Slough, turning this from a small population of 20 otters to over 140 otters today, and all the changes and the benefits in that ecosystem, now we understand that we can take this show on the road. We can try this in other places, and in a rather short period of time, can turn around California's coasts and make them more resilient by putting otters in areas they haven't ranged for decades or perhaps centuries.